time management is not one of them. My relationship, as far as, I mean, this tie-up or what we call it, association with Dolby Atmos, was because I and the team at Balaji believe that it is our prime focus to bring in the best possible entertainment with the best possible experience. The visual experience can be managed with great locations, with the way you shoot, with cinematography, with great locales, but sound. Now, sound is something that needs a specialization, a certain amount of advanced form of capturing, and I think Dolby Atmos is probably the answer to all these questions. However great your visual is, sound is something that is created later, and Dolby Atmos will be our what should I say, medium through which we will hopefully bring in the great, the best possible visual and sound marriage. I'm here to say that I'm extremely honored and proud to be associated with Dolby Atmos. I start with my first film in the next year, one of my first few films called Azar. 2-3 more are in the pipeline that we have signed up with them for. And I'm hoping this association continues for many, many years to come. I'm hoping to bring in with Balaji Motion Pictures and Alt Entertainment a sound and visual experience that enamor and entertain the viewers, because that's my and the company's prime focus. Thank you.
The floor is open. You can have some questions.
Hello. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I'd like to ask you that the biggest change that has happened in Bollywood, according to you.
What is the biggest change in Bollywood, yeah, according to me?
Yeah.
The switch from just pedigree to merit. I think a lot of us came in here with pedigree, and we had to prove ourselves through merit. I think people are way more accepting of fresh talent today, and content that is created by fresh, new people. And I think the importance of pedigree has reduced, and the importance of merit and talent has increased.
Ekta, matlab hum log bahut acche se samajh payenge agar aapko example de, jaise ki aapki aane wali film ab jo agli banegi Azhar pe jo banne wali hai, to usme kya ye Dolby istemal hoga hi, lekin kis tarike se, ha to matlab kis tarike se dhyan rakha jayega ki cricket ka maidan hoga to wo awaaz hogi, thoda sa agar aap agar kis tarike se aap soch rahi hain Dolby aane ke baad us film ke bare mein jab aap sochti hain to kaise sochti hain?
Dekhiye, ye bahut vast question hai. Abhi I cannot tell you in which scene how will we experience, but I mean, we're making a film on a legend, a man who's been a hero, a villain, a victim, a fallen hero, a star. He's been criticized, loved. Every criticism will be heard, every praise will be heard louder. Every sound that you want to hear, maybe even of the heartbeat, will be louder. The experience is not to concentrate on the sound. The experience is to enable the sound to help you concentrate more on the content. So I think that's what's going to be the idea.
इसी फिल्म से जुड़ा एक और सवाल था, अगर
कंफर्टेबल नहीं, फिल्म से जुड़ा हुआ कोई सवाल नहीं लेंगे हम.
क्या आप बता पाएंगे कि करीना क्यों बाहर हो गई?
बिल्कुल, वो एक्चुअली करीना क्यों बाहर हो गई, कहां से?
हर कोई जानना चाहता है, मतलब इस फिल्म से जुड़ी हुई हर बात सबके लिए बहुत बड़ी बात है. कौन होगा जो संगीता जी का रोल होगा, आपके दिमाग में कौन कौन से नाम है? क्या
आई वॉज थिंकिंग संगीता जी खुद, बट आई डोंट थिंक शी एग्री.
Was Kareena approached for this role?
No.
Okay, Ekta, something connected to the technology again.
Yes.
The first time when you ever saw a film, you know, which made you believe that this is what we probably lack in India, and you know, or maybe you know, in audiovisual experience, and in this case, audio especially.
As I said, the beauty of an experience is that you don't really concentrate on only one aspect of it, and it really helps you enhance the whole experience. So if you ask me, for me on a personal level, it was shockingly an action film called Mission Impossible with Tom Cruise, where I actually experienced the power of sound. I don't know if that was a Dolby Atmos film, but that time, I think it was two, three years ago, I realized how advanced Hollywood is as far as sound goes, even in an action film. So you expect that experience in somehow a special effects film. Like Gravity, I was, of course, enamored with the way it was done. But the first time I actually realized on a personal level how important sound is through Mission Impossible. I mean, I was actually sucked in with the power of the way the sound created the ambience.
Ekta, kya? Hello?
I don't know. I'm telling you, I'm so shocked at so many names coming out who I haven't even approached. Can I just do one thing? Can I do this press conference on Dolby Atmos? I swear to meet you all in exactly a month. I'll stand here with who's playing Sangeeta Bijlani and hopefully the real Sangeeta Bijlani and make the announcement. I swear. Otherwise, I don't know. See, already the film is very controversial. It has a lot of questions, a lot of actors ask when you do such a important casting. I am having enough issues to see that I have to stay clear of a lot of controversies. Trust me, there's a reason why I'm not answering many questions here.
Hi, Ekta.
I would like to. See, it's a sound experience. It sometimes may not be necessary, but if it is enhancing the film, why not? But there's no like compulsion here in any contractual way as such. As far as I'm concerned, I'd love to. After Azhar, the other two films that are there, I have been clearly told not to give out the names because I'll mar the announcement. So I'm so sorry, I can't give out the names. But there are some films that Balaji is producing, and hopefully they'll be announced with Dolby Atmos soon.
Well, I think this is very unique that the first time a production company is coming and announcing several titles. So this has not happened for us first. We've had production companies announce a single title, but this is very unique and special because they are making a larger commitment to the format. So.
And also, with your experience in over, I think, 100 screens, how many screens abroad?
900.
What have you learned that we lack in India as far as Dolby atmosphere is concerned, and where you want to make improvement and make it better?
I don't think we lack anything. I think the facilities that are being set up in India are on par with anything else in the world. So I would not say we lack anything. The experience that you would get an Atmos theater like this would be the same you'll get in a top theater in LA, let's say. So there's no lacking, I would say.
You're also aiming at a target of 900 screens in India also, like abroad?
At this stage, as I said, we have 50 screens which have been opened already, because in India, there's a long cycle for getting permissions. There are several screens which are installed but not open. So by middle of the year, we should get to 100. And hopefully by the end of the year, maybe 150 plus numbers. So.
And other than Fun Cinema, which are the other theater chains which have come forward to ask you to join them?
Well, all of the large ones, PVR, Inox, Cinepolis, SPI Cinemas, Prashad, a lot of the chains, all of the chains are installing Dolby Atmos screens in India.
Thank you.
Ekta, as a producer, how much impetus do you put in terms of promoting sound, in terms of the budget that you allocate? And will it also, enable the movie to have a better experience with Dolby Atmos?
As far as percentage allocated to sound, it's different for every film. But yeah, for a film like Azhar, so we'll go brass tacks and specific. There will be a slightly higher budget allocated, and we definitely think Dolby Atmos will help in that experience, because as I said, you have various sounds in stadiums, and especially in a film which is a biopic of sorts, and it's got such strong sense of, you know, euphoria and such high levels of, you know, drama, I think sound will play a very, very important part.
Ekta, aapko lagta hai ki Bollywood mein ab tak sound ko kafi ignore kiya gaya hai?
I think so. Main aapse bilkul sehmat hoon. I think humko khud pata nahi hota ki experience kam kyun pad raha hai jab tak hum ek example khud nahi dekh lete. Like I was saying, these movies like Gravity and Mission Impossible, you realize what sound does. There's so many preempting that we have to do visually that sometimes you can actually leave it to sound, you know, and play on the thought process of a viewer and give the viewer some kind of, you know, experience to probably preempt, or should I say take a strong understanding of something without visually seeing it, you know. We've not been able to depend on sound as much because we haven't really given sound that kind of importance.
Ekta, can you please tell us the cast which you have finalized for Half Girlfriend? I mean, there were reports that Kriti have been finalized. So can you please, if you tell us?
I swear, I have no idea. I would love to the sound of the cast, but I really have only no idea. I swear. Mohit's just about to finish. I think he's just about to finish Hamari Adhuri Kahani, and the moment he gets over with it, we will sit on the casting of Half Girlfriend.
Ekta, what went wrong between you and Ram Gopal Verma? You both were supposed to produce a movie.
Guys, this is supposed to be a Dolby Atmos press conference. There is no problem with Ram Gopal Verma. I think we should just like finish this. I'm.
Ekta, we have asked you a lot of questions in Dolby Atmos. It would be really great.
No. I have no idea what you're saying. I have no problems with Ram.
There was a movie called XCS, right?
It's Triple X.
Triple X. Has it been shelved or?
It's going on floors in March.
With Ram Gopal Verma.
Oh my God! I'm done. Thank you guys. Thank you. Photo up kare. Bop 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 b